These people are committed to investing their time, their energy after work to go and pray for people that don't even know they're being prayed for. And they're committed and committed and committed. And it's such a desirable trait. I haven't heard the word committed in a long, long time. And it's one of those things where it's like, you want to be described as committed. Because that is everything like the best humans look like. The one opposite is a terrible human being. But committed. These people are committed. And it's, you know they're committed because it's time tested. It's very easy to be committed for a day. That's not a commitment. That's like a first step, first decision. It all starts there. But these are time-tested, committed people. It's unwavering regardless of their circumstance and external pressures. And it's regardless of how they feel. They have a commitment to God that is regardless if they feel it or not. And I can guarantee there have been moments that these people did not want to serve. There have been plenty of moments that people have come after work and thinking, I want to attend a prayer meeting because I'm just too tired. But they still commit because they have a conviction. They have a calling that they believe that they are doing God's work, and therefore they will continue to serve and commit regardless of what it is in front of them. And there have been plenty and plenty of moments that these people didn't want to or couldn't, but still. And that's unbelievable commitment. And the impact that these people have on other people's lives around them have been immeasurable. It's just one of those things that you don't know how far your hour of service will go. You don't know how far. I know how far your hour of TV watching will go. That's it. It's gone. That's it. That hour is spent. But an hour spent on serving goes a long, 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 long way. And these people have dedicated. Again, I've pointed out a handful of people, but each one of you have been in these moments. And you know, you have invested and committed and you have seen. But one of the biggest mind shifts that I've had in ministry and service is seeing it outside the context of the church. Because for the longest time, I've always seen it as ministry, God's work, and the marketplace, my regular work. And I always saw it as, hey, I have to do my job, the necessary thing I gotta do, so that I can fund to do the holy work that I do, which is in ministry. So I gotta work so that I have money, so that I can buy petrol, so I can do youth ministry, the holy work. Necessary work versus the holy work. And I always found it so difficult to reconcile. I was like, I need to get into full-time ministry to really live out the calling of God. And once you think about it, it's like full-time ministry is not available to all. So what does that mean? Does that mean you cannot serve? Does that mean you cannot live out the calling of God in your life? Because you can only do a certain amount of time. And I always saw it as separate until someone kind of pointed it out to me. Not even a long time ago, you know, within the last 5 years, where they go, it's all God's work. All of it. All of it that you are doing as a human, as a Christian, it's all God's work. It's all full of purpose and meaning. You just gotta bring it into it. And sometimes we're in a search of going, where is that perfect job so that I can finally feel fulfilled? And finally say that I am living out the life that God, full of my passion, I'm doing what I'm passionate about, I'm making money for what I'm passionate about, I'm living out God's work. And we're in a search looking for, where is God calling me? And completely missing that. You might be exactly where you're supposed to be, but you have to associate the purpose and meaning into it, understanding that it's all God's work. where you currently are, it's God's work. You just have to shift your mind and go, wait, what is God telling me to do here? In my workplace, in my family, in my sports team, in my hobbies, what is God calling me to do? How can I serve these people around me right now? And in Colossians 3, since you have been raised to new life with Christ, set your sights on the realities of heaven, where Christ sits in the place of honor at God's right hand. Think about the things of heaven, not the things of earth. For you died to this life, and your real life is hidden with Christ in God. And when Christ, who is your life, is revealed to the whole world, you will share in all his glory. So put to death the sinful earthly things lurking within you. Have nothing to do with sexual immorality, impurity, lust, and evil desires. Don't be greedy, for a greedy person is an idolater, worshipping the things of this world. Because of these sins, the anger of God is coming. You used to do these things when your life was still part of this world. But now is the time to get rid of anger, rage, malicious behavior, slander, and dirty language. Don't lie to each other, for you have stripped off your old sinful nature and all its wicked deeds. Put on your new nature and be renewed as you learn to know your Creator and become like Him. In this new life, it doesn't matter if you're a Jew or a Gentile, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbaric, uncivilized, slave or free. Christ is all that matters, and He lives in all of us. Since God chose you to be holy people He loves, you must clothe yourselves with tender-hearted mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Make allowance for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Remember, the Lord forgave you, so you must forgive others. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds us all together in perfect harmony. And let the peace that comes from Christ rule in your hearts. For as members of one body, you are called to live in peace and always be thankful. Let this message about Christ and its riches fill your lives. Teach and counsel each other with all the wisdom He gives. Sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs to God with thankful hearts. And whatever you do or say, do it as a representative of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks through Him to God the Father. Paul saying, it's like, hey, your life is changed by Jesus. Let go of everything that your earthly desires used to have. Like, let go of it. You've got a new life. And now extend this to others. Extend all of these things to others. Allow the mercy and the blessing that you've experienced. You need to see it as you are not the final destination of this thing. It goes to you so you can pass it to someone else. You have been extended mercy so you can extend mercy to somebody else. You have been extended love so you can extend love to somebody else. You are not the final destination. It just flows through you. And once you are washed over with the Word of God, with the love of God, it's actually uncontainable. You can't help but share. You can't help but extend. And the hard part about service is because it allows you to extend to people that you feel like they don't deserve it. It's easy to be merciful to someone that's apologetic. It's like, well, of course I'll just extend you mercy. You're always saying sorry, here you go. But someone that's not apologetic, someone that is not remorseful of what they did, extend mercy to that person. That someone that it will squander your blessing, bless them. It's a bit hard. But that's how it works. It works. It extends to people that do not deserve it. Mercy, salvation, we did not deserve it. It was extended to us. and we received it and it changed our lives. It's to flow through. And you can look at it in a way where it's like, hey, what? How can I serve them, Ken? We've been talking about service for the last month. How can I actually serve? And there are different things you can do inside the church. The bathroom needs cleaning, if everyone wants to clean that. I know everyone's had a look at that bathroom and thought, whoo, this is dirty. And that's how it ended. I'm sure everyone has gone through that bathroom like, ooh, someone should want this bathroom service. I'm sure that's like, hey, it would be nice if there was some snacks here. Like, service, you know, you can extend and do things. There's work to be done inside the church. But there's not enough work to keep everyone busy, to keep going. And if we only ever look at service and servanthood in the context of the church, it's very limited. We ignore majority of our lives where we could really make an impact. You ignore the impact of kindness inside your workplace because it's very rare. And so once you extend kindness in the workplace, it's very obvious. Once you extend a strong work ethic in the workplace, it's very obvious. It's unbelievable how low the bar is inside workplaces. Very low. Very low. It's not hard to excel at anyone's workplace. You just have to be the person that doesn't complain, that works harder than everyone else, and just does it with a cheerful heart. And you will excel at your workplace. And these are, you just have to live out the Christian values, the things that we have learned in your workplace, and you will make unbelievable impact. Do not ignore the ministry you have in the marketplace, where you have been called to live it out. And we'd love for you to serve here. We'd love for you to serve in the church. But do not see it as this is all the work versus the work I have to do to pay the bills. It's all God's work. We got to do it all to do the thing, not to extend the kingdom of God. And so, you're actually already committed. You're already committed, you're already dedicated, you're already a loyal person, you're already devoted, you're already dependable. The question is, to what? What are you actually committed to? What has your time? What has your money? What has your attention? That's what you're committed to. And so you're already exercising the attitude of commitment. It's just a matter of committing to the right thing and devoting to your life to the things that are eternal and not to the things that are temporary. So are you committed to the right thing? And the invitation for the last month is to serve, to commit to a life of service. Commit to a life of God's calling. And that will change your life. That will satisfy you to no end. It's unbelievable how satisfying volunteer work is. And at your office, when you're not seeing purpose, no matter how much you get paid, it feels like it's never satisfying. No matter how high the salary is, it just feels like not enough because you don't have purpose in it. But you can volunteer to no end and spend all of your money and feel so satisfied. Do commit yourself to doing the call of life. Having a commitment to service will actually give you the privilege and joy of seeing lives transformed. If you have ever seen a life transformed, you will know how satisfying it is. If you have children, you can see whenever a child transforms into something new, it is the most joyful thing. If you see someone living in sin and suddenly get saved, it is the most satisfying and joyful thing. Committing to a life of service gives you the privilege and joy to see that. And ultimately, it will change you in your heart. The more you serve, the more you will be changed. The more you serve, the bigger your heart becomes. The more you serve, the more desire you have for godly things and less desire you have for earthly things. And if you are a Christian, that is the thing that we are going towards. So the invitation is serve and commit to a life of service. Let's pray. Dear Father, thank you so much for allowing us to experience your joy, the love, the mercy, and everything else that comes with it, Father. Thank you so much, God, that you have saved us. Thank you so much that you have rescued us from our sins. And Lord, we pray that you give us the heart to do the work that you have called us to do. And it could be inside this church, it could be outside of this church, in our families, in our friend groups, wherever it is. Lord, help us see what you are doing in our midst and allow us to have the courage and the desire to do God's work, because this is all your work. And Lord, we want to live lives devoted to you, committed to expanding your kingdom and sharing the gospel.